Well, good Monday morning, everyone. You ready for a new week?
I know I am. I'm very excited about this week on Inspiration for Today. Let me read you the verse for the week, really, because all week we're going to fulfill this verse or encourage you to do so. And it's found in Deuteronomy chapter 4 at verse 9. And it says, "Do not forget the things of the Lord, that your eyes have seen, or let them slip from your heart as long as you live. Teach them to your children and to their children after them." Do you get what that verse is saying? The things that God has taught you and have been a part of your life, the things that you've seen him do, perhaps answered prayer, perhaps other miracles, don't forget them. And then teach them to your children and to their children, your grandchildren. Well, I'm going to tell you stories, faith-building stories this week, every day. But I'm doing this so that my children and grandchildren can see them and hear them. I hope they build your faith. They build my faith. When I get down, I review these because I've seen God work in miraculous ways many times in my life. And I make a point of this verse of not forgetting them. And I encourage you to do so too. Maybe you have to think back before you remember yours. Do that. Think back where you've seen God work and then teach them to your children and grandchildren. The first thing I want to tell you about happened to me, I think it was 1973, toward the end. Might have been early 74. But anyway, the bottom line is, I was in seminary. I went to Talbot Seminary in La Mirada. But Diane and I were living in Costa Mesa, just off of 19th Street. And she was working full-time so that I could go to school for full-time to get my master's degree. But I was really just going because I wanted to learn more about the Bible. I did not intend to go directly into ministry. In fact, I did not do that. But she was working really hard, so I worked really hard and was one of the only two people that got through in the supposed three-year curriculum. But we weren't making it. She was working as a bank teller for Bank of America, and when she'd get her check, we would cash it, literally take the cash, put it into envelopes, only spend that amount that's in that envelope on that category in that amount of time. That's how budgeted we were. And we were just not making it, driving up there, and I was carpooling and all that, but it was impossible to meet our rent. Now, understand, our rent was only $150 a month. I remember that specifically. Money was obviously much more valuable in 1974 than it is today. And we had it budgeted down to the penny. And month after month after month, while I was going to seminary, our savings went down. We did not have credit cards. I can't remember. I assume they were invented by then, but we didn't have any. So it was literally cash to mouth, the food, you know, and we saw many, many times the Lord provided. I was serving as the youth pastor at Mariners Church at that time as a volunteer, no pay for that position at that point in time. And so we were going along, and we had asked for prayer in so many different ways from different people. And then something happened, and we thought we had a tremendous answer to prayer. And by the way, we knew that we were being about $25 short every month. About $25. Isn't that something? Diane and I tried to figure it out, and that probably equates, we think now, to about $500, you know, because everything is about 10 times higher and many things much more than that, but $400 to $500. But it was only 25 then. And so we had asked for prayer because we just weren't making it. And then somebody offered us their home free of charge in La Mirada, right by the seminary. I would not have to spend money on gas. We would save the $150. And the reason they were doing that is the house was empty, and all we would have to do is do the upkeep and outside maintenance in the yard and all that, which I was, of course, gladly to do. And here's the thing, we're rejoicing. Wouldn't you have? And you'd say, wow, God is so good. He answered my prayer. And then I talked to my pastor, the pastor that I was working with at Mariners. His name actually was Bill Acton, if any of you old Mariners people are watching. And Bill said, well, that's interesting that somebody has offered you that house, but how do you know that you're supposed to take it? And I said, Bill, of course we're supposed to take it, I said. It's the answer to prayer, isn't it? This, we'll be able to get through seminary. It's like God really meeting our needs. And then he said to me, but did God call you to minister to our junior hires at Mariners or not? And I said, he did. I know he did. And then Bill said, well, how do you know then that he's calling you out of that ministry? And I said, well, because he supplied us a house. Bill replied, would you do me this one favor? Would you pray and ask God for 2 weeks to supply your need in some other way so that you can answer the call of God here at Mariners to those junior hires? And I, oh, Bill, do I have to? Because I was so excited about, you know, we would have had extra money and so forth, but I said I would. And then you never imagine what would happen. During that 2 weeks, out of the blue, not even somebody who would have ever heard the prayer, they didn't live in this area. It was my grandmother's brother, who we rarely saw, actually. But he called us out of the blue. I probably hadn't talked to him in a year or more. I can't remember that. But he says, out of the blue, he says, we have decided, his wife and he had decided that they wanted to call and offer to give us $25 per month till the end of my seminary years. And I go, that's unbelievable. That's the exact amount that we knew we were short per month. The lesson for me was, and we said we rejoice in that because that has to be of God. When it's the exact $25 that we knew we were short, it would allow us to finish seminary, and it did. And secondly, it would allow us to finish our commitment to the call of God for us for junior high ministry at Mariners Church. And my lesson and Diane's lesson was so clear. We had seen there was no other explanation to us other than that God had supplied our need in his way, in his way. And that lesson stayed with us, has stayed with us our whole life. We can make decisions based on what God would have us to do rather than what we would choose. Well, we're going to have another faith-building story tomorrow. Hope you'll join us. See you then. Bye.